Now there'll be questions in Binomial Theorem where we need to use greatest near function and fraction part function to solve certain problems. Say for example, a question is given as x equals 8 plus 3 root 7 to the power n, where n is a natural number, and this box represents greatest near function. So it says, prove that the integral part of this binomial expression is an odd integer, and also we need to find the value of x minus x square plus x into greatest near function of x. Now here what I'll do is, I'll take this x common. So if I'll take x common, I can write x, and it is 1 minus, I'll take minus also common, so this is x minus greatest near function of x. So x minus greater function of x is nothing but its fraction part of x. So I need to find x into 1 minus fractional part of x. Now in this question we have both greatest near function as well as fractional part function. So what do we do in this question is, I'll write this 8 plus 3 root 7 as greatest near function of x plus fraction part of x, and I'll write fraction part of x as f. Now I know that in this case the value of f will lie between 0 and 1 because it's not an integer, so this value it will always have some fractional part and which will be between 0 and 1. Now I'll take up another binomial expression which is the conjugate of this expression, so I'll write 8 minus 3 root 7 to the power n, and I'll say this value is f. Now make sure when we are taking this conjugate of the given expression, this value 8 minus 3 root 7 to the power n, it should always lie between 0 and 1. Now we know that 8 plus 3 root 7 into 8 minus 3 root 7 is equal to 1. Now 8 minus 3 root 7 is 1 upon 8 plus 3 root 7. So this value is less than 1. So I can say that the value of capital F will lie between 0 and 1. So now if I'll expand these two series, I can write from the first one, I can write greatest near function of x plus f is nc0 a to the power n nc1 a to the power n minus 1 3 under root 7 nc2 a to the power n minus 2 3 root 7 whole square. And from the second series, I can write f is nc0 a to the power n minus nc1 a to the power n minus 1 3 root 7 plus nc2 a to the power n minus 2 3 root 7 whole square. Now, from these two series, I need to cancel out the terms having under root sign. So in this case, if I'm going to add the two series, then these terms containing square root, they'll get cancelled. So I'll add them up. So if I'll add them up, I'll write greater function of x plus small f plus capital F, there'll be. So here, this term will cancel. So I'll get 2 times nc0 a to the power n, nc2 a to the power n minus 2 into 3 under root 7 whole square. So whenever I have this irrational part, I'm having an even part. So this expression on the right hand side, it is nothing but an even integer. Now what about f plus f? What I know is the value of f lies between 0 and 1. Value of capital F also will lie between 0 and 1. So if I add them up, from here I can say the value of f plus f will lie between 0 and 2. Now greatest near function of x, it is an integer. Right hand side is also an integer. So it simply means the value of this f plus f, it should also be an integer. So the only integral value possible in this case is 1. So from here I can say value of f plus capital F, it should be 1. So that is greatest near function of x plus 1. It should be an even integer. That is greatest near function of x should be even integer minus 1, so there'll be an odd integer. So from here we can say the greatest integer part for this given binomial expression is an odd integer. Now if I look at the second part is simply, I need to find the value of x into 1 minus fraction part of x. So this is x into 1 minus And we have taken this fraction part as f. So 1 minus f. So this is x. And what I know is f plus f is 1. So 1 minus small f is capital F. So it is x into capital F. What is x? X is 8 plus 3 under root 7 to the power n. And what is capital F? Capital F is 8 minus 3 under root 7 to the power n. So if I'll multiply them, I'll get what? 64 minus 63 to the power n, which is 1. So answer to the second part is 1. So the value of this expression is nothing but 1. If you like the video, consider subscribing and sharing it with someone you know who might benefit from it. Also, the best way to navigate any topic is through a playlist. Simply go to the channel page, click playlist, and select the topic you wish to study.